welcome Tiger fans to the season opener here at Paul Brown Tiger Stadium. Tonight is sure to be a great matchup between the Massillon Tigers and the Akron St. Vincent St. Mary Fighting Irish. The Irish ended last season with a 10-4 record. Some key players for the Irish are quarterback Luke Lindsay and running back Karen Keyes. The Tigers finished the previous season with a 10-4 record. Last season, the Tigers were able to make the Division II Region 7 championship before falling to Cincinnati and the Division II State Championship. Some key players to look for for the Tigers are Aiden Longwell, Trayvon Morgan, Tyree Boyle, Peter Thomas, Marcellus Blake, and Dean Clark.
Everyone here at WHS-TV would like to thank the following sponsors for their financial support of tonight's game. Reliable Heating and Cooling, Cosmos Grill, Yule and Oliveri Insurance, Expert Auto Collision, Tower Industries, Discount Tire Outlet, Friends and Family Credit Union, Massillon YMCA, Stark State College, Downtown Massillon Association, John George's Convenience Store, Bonnie's and Graver's Gallery, Medicap Pharmacy, Buffalo Wild Wings and Massillon, Your Pizza Shop, WHS Alumni Association, Massillon Quick Print, Mercy Health Center, Home Appliance, The Music Shop, ManCan, Massillon AAA, and MCTV.
Soon to get underway. It's sure to be an exciting one here tonight. Usually this game takes place second to last for the Tigers on the season, but this year it'll be the season opener for the Tigers. These two teams have almost formed a rivalry over the past couple years, with every matchup being very intense. Last year's matchup between the two teams, the Irish defeated the Tigers 13-10 here at Paul Brown Tiger Stadium. The Irish will kick the ball off. Back deep for the Tigers, number 8, Tyree Broyles, and number 9, Jaden Ballard. Jaden Ballard started as a freshman last season. Tyree Broyles having two great seasons the last 2 years, switching from corner to wide receiver this year. And the kick is off, and the game is underway. Tyre Boyles fumbling the kick. He breaks free, and he's down at the 33-yard line. Number 8, Tyree Broyles, after a muff kick, a very good game to start off for the Tigers. It'll be 1st and 10 for the Tigers, ball on the 40. Aiden Longwell back at quarterback. Jameer Thomas at running back. A pass. Pass to number 32, Adrian Ford. And that'll be a loss of 3, it looks like. Tigers will need to get their offense going quick here tonight. Second and 12. Ball on the 33. Hand off to Jameer Thomas. Gaining positive yards. That'll bring up 3rd down and 6 on the 39 for the Tigers. Tigers already facing their first 3rd down. Number 7, Trayvon Morgan in motion. Longwell drops back, passes, and it's deflected by the Irish. Tigers will have to punt this one away. Starting off the game with a 3 and out. That's not too good for the Tigers. Back deep for the Irish, number 13, Joshua Jones. Great punt, covered at the 25. And he'll be taken down at the 39. A very minimal gain for Jones. And now the Irish offense will hit the field. First and 10, ball on the 30. 10:31 remaining. Back at quarterback, number 9, Luke Lindsay. By Lindsay, and he'll gain about 4 yards on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 6. Ball on the 34, the Irish. Drops back to pass. But he gets out of there as he was rushed. He makes a big gain. That'll be a first down for the Irish. Number 9, Luke Lindsay, gets out of the backfield. That'll make it first and 10, ball on the 45 for the Irish. The Irish looking to have a very run-heavy oriented offense this year. A handoff to number 34, Terrence Keyes. Short gain by Keyes. That'll make it second and 8, ball on the 47. 9:19 remaining in the first. Drops back the pass, he rolls out. Pass to number 13, Joshua Jones, but he's hit right as he catches the ball. That'll be another first down for the Irish. First and 10, ball on the 42 for the Irish. Irish offense having errors causing a turnover. Massillon will take over, ball on the 45. Handoff to number 16, Jameer Thomas. He'll gain about 3 yards on the run. They get second and 6, ball on the 49. Pass caught by number 32, Adrian Ford, as he dances in the backfield, and he'll only gain about a yard on the play. That'll make it third and 4 for the Tigers, ball on the 49. The Tigers' last possession, they were not able to convert on third down. Let's hope we can see different from the Tigers this possession. Hand off. And that'll be a first down for the Tigers. Flag on the play. Number 16, Jameer Thomas with the run. Tigers will move the sticks up even further on this drive as they were able to pick up the first down on the play. First down, ball on the 39. Hand off to Jameer Thomas as he runs straight into the guy and runs him over with a short gain of about two. Second and nine for the Tigers. The Tigers look to run the ball a lot this season with great running backs in the backfield like Jameer Thomas. Another handoff to Jameer Thomas, and he breaks away for a big game. That'll be another first down for the Tigers. Pass to number nine, Jaden Ballard. Looks to be no gain on the play. Second and nine, ball on the 26. 6:16 remaining in the first. Number 29, Zion Pfeiffer, in at running back for the Tigers. Hand off to Zion Pfeiffer, and he'll be hit right at the line, maybe gaining about a yard on the play. Third and nine for the Tigers. Aiden Longwell, back pass. Pass number seven, Trayvon Morgan. And he's taken down about a gain of three. Which will bring up fourth down for the Tigers. Fourth and seven for the Tigers. Tigers look to be going for it here on fourth down. Tigers with majority running yards this game so far, with 27 running yards, only three passing yards. Aiden Longwell, number three, 32, Adrian Ford, and that's touchdown for the Tigers. Aiden Longwell to number 32, Adrian Ford. For the first Tiger touchdown of the season. What a pass and what a catch. The extra point is good. The Tigers lead the Irish 7-0 here at the first with 4:51 remaining. The Tigers with a very run-oriented offense.
Now from a word from WHS Alumni Association.
Just what does the Washington High School Alumni Association do?
Why, every year, we honor select grads as distinguished citizens.
This past spring, we awarded 27 scholarships, averaging $1,000 each.
We keep you connected through class reunions and birthday parties.
We also sponsor the WHS Homecoming, Alumni Band, and the Choir Alumni.
So join and contribute today, the Washington High School Alumni Association.
A Massillon staple for over 40 years, Massillon Quick Print is your one-stop shop for all your printing needs. Before you shop the internet, come downtown to see Massillon Quick Print first. Experience their top-notch customer service and offset printing capabilities. They also specialize in copy services, print media, brochures, invitations, and much more. Visit Massillon Quick Print on 1st Street Northeast in downtown Massillon.
Thank you, WHS Alumni Association and Massillon Quick Print. Now let's get back to the game.
Number 25, Russell Cooper III with the ball as he dances. He'll be taken down about the 25-yard line. The last possession for the Irish ended in a fumble after a few mistakes with two guys colliding and causing a fumble where the Tigers recovered and drove down the field to score. First and 10 for the Irish, ball at 25. Handoff to number 34, Terrence Keys, and he stopped at the line of scrimmage. He powers through for maybe a gain of one on the short one. That'll bring up second and 8, ball on the 27. Lindsay back in the backfield alone. Terrence Keys motion. Lindsay takes it and runs. That'll be about a 8-yard gain for Lindsay. Bring up a first down for the Irish. First and 10, ball on the 35 for the Irish. 3:53 remaining. Pass to number, that pass will be completed to number 25, Russell Cooper III. That'll make it second and 3rd for the Irish. In the backfield, and that'll be offsides. Iris jumping. That'll take the ball back after that, after the pass. Making it 2nd and 8. Ball in 37 after the mistake from the Irish O-line. Hand off to number 34, Terrence Keys, and he's scooped up in the backfield. Tiger defense performing great out here. That'll be a loss of 2 yards on the play. 3rd and 10. 2:20 remaining. The Tiger defense looking to play very aggressive here tonight. Lindsay drops back to pass. And he's rushed. And he's taken down. That'll bring up fourth down for the Irish. They'll have to punt it away. Tiger defense looking very strong out there right now. Back deep for the Tigers, number 9, Jaden Ballard. Number 32, Adrian Ford. The kick will bounce back. It'll be picked up at about the 34-yard line. That'll be first and 10, ball on the 35 for the Tigers. Their last possession ended in a touchdown. A minute 20 remaining in the first. And the ball is dropped by number 32, Adrick Ford. Low throw by quarterback Aiden Longwell. That'll bring up second and 10. Hand off to Zion Pfeiffer. And he'll get about 4 yards on the short run. Third and 6 for the Tigers. The Tigers so far with 3 first downs. All coming in their previous possession. Third and 6, ball on the 39. It'll be a timeout.
Now for a quick word from Mancan.
If you're searching for a local business that can match area employers with potential quality workers, look no further than Mancan in downtown Massillon. Mancan Temporary Staffing Employment Agency has been locally owned and operated since 1976 and serves Stark County and beyond. They have the most creative and technological recruiting process in the industry. Mancan also features the most tenured professional staffing specialists in the business. If you're looking for a career and not just a job, visit Mancan on First Street Northeast in downtown Massillon.
Your first set of wheels didn't come with complications or strings or hassles. It can be that way again. There's a simpler way to buy tires at Tire Pros.
We're hassle-free, guaranteed.
Thank you, Mancan and Discount Tyler Outlet. Let's get back to the game.
Aiden Longwell, a long pass to number 9, Jaden Ballard, but it is overthrown. That'll bring up fourth down. Tigers will have to punt it away. That was great coverage by the St. V defense. Back deep for the Irish, number 13, Joshua Jones. Good punt from the Tigers. And a muffed and out of bounds at the 20. First and 10, ball on the 20 for the Irish. The Irish will look to even the score of this drive. Lindsay the pet. Screen pass over to number 25, Russell Cooper III, as he runs out of bounds. Second and one for the Irish. The ball on the 29. 12 seconds remaining in the first. Lindsay drops back, and he runs. He'll get the first down and more, and he'll be taken down around the 40-yard line. Quarterback Luke Lindsay for the Irish has had some amazing runs here tonight. The Tigers will have to find a way to stop him if they expect to win this game. That'll make a first and 10 on the 40 after the first down. That'll be the end of the first. Tiger 7, Irish 0.
Now for a word from Friends and Family Credit Union.
Welcome to our newly renovated downtown office of Friends and Family Credit Union.
Hello, I'm Nick Langenfeld, President and CEO of Friends and Family Credit Union. Friends and Family Credit Union provides loans, savings, checking, and other financial services to anyone who lives, works, worships, or attends school in Stark County. We provide financial needs in the most reasonable and cost-effective way. Stop in one of our three full-service locations today and become a friend of the family.
Mercy comes to Massillon. Mercy Health Center and StatCare of Massillon is proud to introduce our Mercy Physicians. Pravi Pawa is certified by the American Board of Family Medicine. Lisa Vaughn is certified by the American Osteopathic Board of Family Practice. Both physicians are ready to provide immediate care of minor illnesses and injuries with no appointment necessary. Visit 2935 Lincoln Way West, Massillon, or call 330-236-2300. That's 330-236-2300.
Thank you, Friends and Family Credit Union and Mercy Health Center. Let's get back to the game.
First and 10 for the Irish. The pass, but it'll be incomplete. Looks like the quarterback was targeting number 23, Garrett Bischoff, but pass seemed to be way off. Miscommunication by the quarterback and the receiver. That'll bring up second and 10 here at the beginning of the second quarter. Lindsay drops back, and it's deflected by the Tiger. Look to be number 16, Jameer Thomas making the deflection. That'll bring up third down for the Irish. Once again, no gain. He rolls out to pass. Pass is number 13. Joshua Johnson. That'll be 2 yards off of the first down. Making it fourth and two. Ball on the 48. Going to go for it here on fourth down. Handoff. And that'll be a first down for the Irish, just getting past the mark. That'll be first and 10 for the Irish. Ball on the 49. Handoff to number 25, Russell Cooper III. He'll get a short gain on the run. 3 to 4 yards as he's pushed out of bounds. That'll bring up second and 6 for the Irish. .10:55 remaining in the half. Lindsay passes to number 25, Russell Cooper. And it's incomplete. He's hit as he gets a hold of the ball. That'll stay Irish's ball. After a great hit from the Tiger defense. That'll bring up third down and 6 for the Irish. Tigers once again looking to stop the Irish in their path. Lindsay drops back. He's rushed, but he runs. And he will just make it to the first down marker on the run. That'll be really close to a first. Bring up another fourth down for the Tigers. He's number 9, Luke Lindsay. Rolled out for a big gain for the Irish. Bring up fourth and 1 for the Irish, ball on the 30. Irish looking for going for it again here on fourth down. Last time they went for it on fourth down during this drive, it was successful. They look to do it again. It'll be a pass, and it's caught by number 36. Another first for the Irish. First and 10, ball on the 34. Luke Sinzi passes. That'll be another first for the Irish. Pass to number 23, Garrett Bischoff. That'll be another first down for the Irish. First and 10, ball on the 22. 9:37 remaining in the half. Hand off to another 34, Terrence Keys. He'll get a short gain. The Irish seem to be switching up their game plan after their first two possessions. Starting off the game running a lot. Now switching to passing. Second and 7. Irish looking to tie up this game. Luke Lindsay passes to number 13, Joshua Jones, and that'll be a touchdown for the Irish. That was a great catch by number 13, Joshua Jones. Irish looking to tie up the game with the extra point. And the kick is good, making this game 7-7 here in the second quarter with 8:53 remaining. Right.
Now a word from Stark State College.
No matter where you are in life, Stark State is the smart choice. The lowest tuition rate in the area, along with flexible schedules, online courses, and degrees that lead to in-demand careers or make it easy to continue your education. Small classes, professors with real-world experience, and a campus close to home. Plus, more than 95% of Stark State grads secure a job or continue their education. Choose Stark State College. Spend less. Earn more. Go further. Register now.
At Cosmo's Grill in downtown Massillon, they're just different enough. Cosmo's Grill is located in a 150-year-old renovated historic building that features a wonderful dining atmosphere. Try their award-winning stone hearth wood-fired pizzas, or how about their tasty homemade soups? Enjoy a great meal featuring your favorite appetizers, salads, and desserts. And don't forget about their seafood, pasta, and sandwiches. So just how different is Cosmo's? Just different enough. Visit Cosmo's Grill in downtown Massillon.
Thank number you, Stark State College and Cosmo's Grill.
Number 8, Tyree Broyles running down the field. He's got an opening, and he's gone! Number 8, Tyree Broyles with the kick return. Answering the Irish with a kick return. What a run by number 8, Tyree Broyles. What an athlete Tyree Broyles. He has phenomenal speed. And the kick is good, making it 14-7 Tigers. Answering back after the Irish score. What a run by number 8, Tyree Broyles.
A quick word from Home Appliance.
Home Appliance Company has been serving Northeast Ohio since 1975, and we look forward to serving Massillon and the surrounding communities for many years to come. Our experts specialize in helping you find the appliances that work for your home and family. Visit our showroom to see the latest in name brand products, including Frigidaire, GE, Maytag, and many more. At Home Appliance Company, you'll get best in product, best in service, and best in price. Stop by or find our full line of products online.
Tower Industries. Now let's get back to the game.
Tigers about to kick it off after a very nice kick return by number 8 Tyree Broyles. 14-7 Tigers here in the second quarter. 8:37 remaining. The kicks off. Number 25. Russell Cooper the third with the run. He'll get to the 25, making it first and 10 on the 25 for the Irish. 8:30 remaining in the half. Irish looking to answer back after that kick return. Luke Lindsay dropping back. Pass to number 21, Logan Olson. He'll get the first. They get first and 10, ball on the 39. Handoff, number 34, Terrence Keys, but he'll be sacked for a loss. That'll be a 5-yard loss, making it second and 15 for the Irish. Lindsay drops back for the Irish. The Tigers come with pressure. And that'll be caught after it's bobbled by number 34, Terrence Keys. The Irish ball on the 34. Then he drops back again, and he'll be rushed heavily, almost sacked. He'll run, and he'll be taken down with only about a gain of 2. That'll bring a 4th down for the Irish. They'll have to punt this one away. The Massillon defense bringing a lot of pressure here tonight. bring up another fourth down. Back deep for the Tigers, number 9, Jaden Ballard. Number 32, Adric Ford. Adric Ford with the ball. He'll dance around, but he's running backwards. And he will run backwards. That was not good for the Tigers. He'll go down around the 14-yard line. Mistakes like that cannot happen here tonight for the Tigers. Ford was trying to make a play and just it backfired for the Tigers. First and 10, ball on the 15. Hand off to Zion Pfeiffer. He'll gain maybe a yard on the run. Second and 9 for the Tigers. 5:12 remaining in the half. Longwell rolls out and pass is complete to number 19, Dean Clark. That'll bring up 3rd and 2 for the Tigers. Ball on the 23. Hand off to number 16, Jameer Thomas. And he'll be stopped short of the first. Bringing up 4th down for the Tigers. Massillon will be forced to punt here in the second. 3:45 remaining. Number 13, Joshua Jones, back deep for the Irish. Almost blocked. And the punt goes out of bounds. Around the 49. That'll be great position for the Irish. First and 10, ball on the 40. The Irish with great field position. 3:24 remaining in the half. Lindsay drops back, he rolls out, and the pass is deflected by number 18 for the Tigers. Bringing up 2nd and 10 for the Irish. The Tiger defense gonna try to stop the Irish before they can get any more of this field tore down. Luke Lindsay pulls the ball. He'll get about a 5-yard gain on the play. Stop by. The Irish wanting to score here before the half. .255 remaining in the half. Third and five, ball on the 35. Luke Lindsay, and the pass is dropped by number 34, Terrence Keys, bringing up fourth and five for the Irish. Fourth and five, ball in the 35. The Irish look to go for it. 2:31 remaining in the half. Timeout from the Tigers.
Now a word from Massillon YMCA.
Hi, my name is Jim Stanford. I'd like to welcome you to the YMCA of Western Starr County, where we have been serving our community for almost 100 years.
Everybody is welcome at the YMCA, regardless of their inability to pay.
This is where you get strong, and we'll help you do that.
Welcome to the Massillon YMCA Child Care, where we offer full-day preschool, before and after school in the Massillon and Perry School District, as well as summer camp.
You can do it all here at the YMCA.
If you're like most people, your life is a series of brushstrokes, large and small. Moments from the everyday to the extraordinary. As you move through your world, let Grange Insurance and an independent agent put the finishing touches on an insurance plan to meet your needs. Now, that's a stroke of genius.
Buell and Oliveri Insurance is your Grange independent agent in Massillon. For auto, home, life, or business insurance, call or visit our website today.
Thank you, Massillon YMCA and Buell and Oliveri Insurance. Let's get back to the game.
And the Tigers will stop the Irish. That'll be a turnover on downs. What a stop from the Massillon defense. That'll bring up first and 10, ball on the 35 for the Tigers. 2:28 remaining in the half. The Tiger offense has not been able to pick it up since their first touchdown. They're going to look to change that here in this drive. Aiden Longwell passes to number 9, Jaden Ballard. But it'll be a loss of yards. That'll make it 2nd and 11. Ball on the 34. The Tigers running a lot of screen passes here tonight, none of which have worked out too well. Aiden Longwell drops back, pass to number 32, Adric Ford, and it's caught on the 40. He's still going, and he'll be taken out of bounds around the 28-yard line. What a pass, and what a catch. The Tigers finally looking to be getting it going here on offense. First and 10, ball on the 30. A minute 46 remaining. Hand off to number 16, Jameer Thomas. And he'll get a good run on that play. It'll be about an 8-yard run. Another handoff to number 16, Jameer Thomas. And he'll break free. Oh. He'll be tripped up around the 5-yard line. Jameer Thomas with the big run. That'll make it first and 4. Ball on the 4 for the Tigers. Handoff to number 16, Jameer Thomas. He'll gain about 2 yards on the play. A minute left to go. Second to go. It'll be a timeout by the Irish.
Now a quick word from Expert Auto Collision and Reliable Heating and Cooling.
For nearly 40 years, Expert Auto Collision has been serving Stark County with premium customer service and collision repair. Bring your wrecked vehicle and they'll immediately get to work with you and your insurance company to get your vehicle back to pre-accident condition. Expert Auto Collision's professional crew has the experience and the drive to bring your damaged vehicle back to life.
Don't let an accident get your goat. Come see me, Tara, at Expert Auto Collision, the only female-owned and operated collision repair center in Northeast Ohio.
Expert Auto Collision, where we meet good people by accident.
Thank you, Expert Auto Collision. Now let's get back to the game.
Tigers looking to score here. Go up by 2 touchdowns before the half with a minute remaining. Hand off to Jameer Thomas, and he's in for the Tiger touchdown. The Tigers with a great drive here, right before the end of the half. After a great defensive stop. Jameer Thomas so far having a great night. The extra point is good. That'll make it 21-7 Tigers.
Now a quick word from Reliable Heating and Cooling.
There was a time when 10 miles to the gallon was acceptable. Today's 40-plus mile per gallon cars weren't even in the rearview mirror back then. Of course, this Lennox air conditioner wasn't on the radar either. It's solar ready, the quietest, most energy-efficient air conditioner you can own. It's time to live in the now.
Call Reliable Heating and Cooling for the most advanced technology in heating and air conditioning. When you're ready to live in the now, call Reliable Heating and Cooling.
Lennox. Innovation never felt so good.
The Music Shop on Erie Street North in Massillon is ready to assist anyone in Stark County and surrounding communities. The Music Shop has a great selection of instruments for sale. Not ready to buy? See their wide variety of instrument rentals. Do you need a repair? They'll do anything from touch-up work to full overhauls. In some cases, same-day service is available. See their upstairs recording studio for small or large studio projects. Visit the Music Shop in Massillon and be sure to like them on Facebook.
Thank you, Reliable Heating and Cooling, and the Music Shop. Let's get back to the game.
The Irish with 56 seconds to hopefully score here before the end of the half. Kick will be recovered at about the 11-yard line, and he'll be taken down at about the 23. The Irish with 50 seconds to try and take this game down to a one-score game before the half. We'll start their drive off on the 22nd hard line. Lindsay drops back for the Irish. Passes to number 13. 13, Joshua Jones, as he's hit hard after getting the first. First and 10, ball on the 37 for the Irish. 38 seconds remaining. Looks like there's an injury on the field. First and 10, ball on the 37. 38 seconds remaining in the half. Lindsay, he'll run. He'll run for about a 5-yard gain. Twenty-six seconds remaining in the half. The Irish with only one touchdown. I mean, one timeout. That'll be another timeout from the Tigers.
Catch Massillon Tiger football all season long on WHS-TV. Tune in next week when the Tigers go on the road and face Glen Oak. Watch for the replays on WHS-TV from September 1st through September 4th. Watch the Tigers and the Golden Eagles next weekend on WHS-TV. Find WHS-TV on MCTV channel 611 and 11.
Second and 6. Ball on the 41. Luke Lindsay rolls out. Passes number 21, Logan Olson. 22 seconds remaining in the half. That'll be a first down for the Irish. First and 10, ball on the 48. 22 seconds left, one timeout. Quick pass to number 13, Joshua Jones. 14 seconds left. And the Irish will use their final timeout with 14 seconds left.
A quick word from your pizza shop.
Serving the Massillon area since the 1960s, your pizza shop, located on Massillon's west side, has great tasting pizza and a whole lot more. Their large menu includes pizza, wings, pressure fried chicken, oven-baked subs, and much more. Enjoy their hearty buffet Thursday through Sunday. Don't forget their convenient drive-through window and delivery service. Be sure to visit any one of their numerous locations in Northeast Ohio. When you're ready for great pizza and more, stop into Your Pizza Shop, located on Massillon's west side.
Thank you, Your Pizza Shop. Let's get back to the game.
During the break, incomplete pass from the Irish. That'll bring up third and three, 12 seconds remaining in the half. Zero timeouts left. Flag on the play. Looks to be on the Irish. And it'll go back. False start. This is not the time for mistakes. That'll take the Irish farther back. Third and eight. 12 seconds left in the half. Lindsay rolls out. He's rushed. It'll be a fumble. He'll recover the ball. And he'll run out of bounds with 5 seconds remaining. That'll be a first down for the Irish. Lindsay with a lot of big runs as the Tigers bring pressure. First and 10, ball on the 41. 5 seconds remaining is about enough time for one more play. Lindsay will roll out. And he'll escape tackle. And it'll be an incomplete pass to end the half. Tigers 21, Irish 7. What an exciting first half.
We'll be back to the Massillon Tiger Swing Band after this word from Man Cam.
For nearly 20 years, Bonnie's Engravers Gallery and Signs in downtown Massillon has been your one-stop shopping destination for all things printing. Whether it be small projects like business cards, coffee mugs, and plaques, or larger items like personalized vital cutouts or full-color digital imprinting. Their laser engraver is perfect for name tags and desk plates, and don't forget their large selection of trophies and photo frames. Once Bonnie's has your business logo, they can put it on just about anything. You can even bring in your own items to have personalized. Stop in today at Bonnie's Engravers Gallery and Signs. Thank you.
me, boy. Is that the Chattanooga Juju? Carmichael and Stuart Gorrell. This next song, often associated with Ray Charles, who recorded it in 1960 and helped to make it Georgia's official state song. Our arrangements begins with a trumpet solo from Matt Hersher. Here's an old sweet song, Georgia on My Mind. The band presents a swinging song, first recorded in 1931 by Cab Calloway and his orchestra. With Jordan Higgins on the trumpet and Malik Peloso on vocals, you'll certainly know when to sing along to Minnie the Moocher.
of $1 million with the nickels and dimes. She sat around and counted it a million times. Honey, 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 honey,
word from Mankin.
If you're searching for a local business that can match area employers with potential quality workers, look no further than Mankin in downtown Massillon. Mankin Temporary Staffing Employment Agency has been locally owned and operated since 1976 and serves Stark County and beyond. They have the most creative and technological recruiting process in the industry. Mankin also features the most tenured professional staffing specialist in the business. If you're looking for a career and not just a job, visit Mankin on 1st Street Northeast in downtown Massillon.
Thank you, Mankin. Let's get back to the action.
We're going to be getting back to the game here soon. Just a little recap of the first half. Tigers up 21-7 after a very good first half. Defensively, the Tigers only allowed one touchdown and were able to almost completely stop the Irish run game. But the Tigers offense has had some trouble with only two of the three touchdowns coming from them. The other coming off of a kick return from number 8, Tyree Broyles. An amazing run from him. The Tiger offense will have to come out good once they get the ball here tonight to hopefully keep this lead and gain more. But we'll start off with the defense as the Irish will receive the ball here in the second half.
Everyone here at WHS-TV would like to thank the following sponsors for their financial support of tonight's game. Reliable Heating and Cooling, Cosmos Grill, Buell and Oliveri Insurance, Expert Auto Collision, Tower Industries, Discount Tire Outlet, Friends and Family Credit Union, Massillon YMCA, Stark State College, Downtown Massillon Association, John George's Convenience Store, Bonnie's Engraver's Gallery, Medicap Pharmacy, Buffalo Wild Wings in Massillon, Your Pizza Shop, WHS Alumni Association, Massillon Quick Print, Mercy Health Center, Home Appliance, The Music Shop, Mankin, Massillon AAA, and MCTV. Be sure to tune in every Wednesday night following the Nate Moore Show for Swing on WHS-TV. Each week on Swing, Tiger Swing Band director Jason Neal gives us the latest news from the Swing Band and previews the upcoming halftime show. Join us for Swing every Wednesday night following the Nate Moore Show on WHS-TV. Find WHS-TV on MCTV channels 611 and 11.
Tonight's our first time streaming Tiger football. It's crazy. We have viewers from Japan. We have viewers from Alaska. We have viewers from all over the place. It's an amazing feat here for our program. We'd like to thank everyone tuning in on live stream as well. The second half soon to get underway. Tigers will kick it off. Back deep for the Irish. Number 25, Russell Cooper III, and number 13, Joshua Jones. And the second half is underway. Russell Cooper III receives the kick. He gets through a few guys. He's got a lane. He's down 40, 30, and he's pulled out of bounds around the 25. He's actually pulled down near the 25. Almost the second kick return of this game, but this time by the Irish. Number 25, Russell Cooper III. But it looks like there's an injury on the field.
We hope you're enjoying our coverage of Massillon Tiger football on WHS-TV. Did you know WHS-TV is everywhere on digital media? Be sure to like us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And don't forget to subscribe to us on WHS-TV's YouTube channel, where you can see some great of WHS-TV's best moments.
The Irish with great field position, looking to take this down to a one-score game after the great return by Russell Cooper. Number 9, Luke Lindsay, with an amazing first half, leading the Irish. It'll be a handoff to number 4, Terrence Keys, and he'll break a few tackles up, and he'll go down for a short gain of about 3. That'll bring up 2nd and 8 for the Irish. Ball on the 23. Lindsay drops back. Pass to number 1. He'll gain about 1 yard on the play. Pass to number six. That'll bring up third down and seven. Ball on the 22. Tigers looking to not allow the Irish to score after that huge return. Lindsay drops back. And it's intercepted by the Tigers. That'll be the second turnover of the night for the Irish. Massillon will take over first and 10 on the 15-yard line. Massillon's offense, first time on the field for the half. Flag flies. Delay a game on Massillon. These mistakes can't happen for Massillon, especially this far back. That'll make it first and 15, ball on the 10. Longwell drops back, pass to number 32, Adric Ford, and he'll be pushed out of bounds around the 14-yard line. That'll make it second and 10 for the Tigers. .10:08 remaining in the third quarter. Hand off to Jameer Thomas. He has a lane, but he is tripped up. It'll be about a 6-yard gain for Thomas. Thomas also having a very good night. That'll make it third and 4 for the Tigers, hoping to keep this drive going. Third and 4, I mean. Hand off to Thomas, and he's able to get the first down and more. Great run by Jameer Thomas. That'll bring up first and 10 on the 37-yard line for the Tigers. Another handoff to Thomas. About a 5-yard gain. Tigers' first drive going well so far. Second and 5. Handoff to Zion Pfeiffer. He finds a hole and he'll get a first down. That'll be first and 10 for the Tigers. 8:50 remaining in the third quarter. First and 10, ball on the 48. Another handoff to Pfeiffer. And he will be hit behind the line of scrimmage. Short gain on the play. Second and 10 for the Tigers. The Tigers running the ball very well here in the second half. Longwell throws it out to Trayvon Morgan, and he just misses it. That'll bring up third and 10 for the Tigers. After the incomplete pass. Longwell drops back, and he runs. Maybe just short of the first down. That'll bring up fourth and one for the Tigers. After the great run from Longwell. Ball on the 43-yard line. Hand off to Zion Pfeiffer, and he is stopped. That'll be a turnover on downs. That'll make it Irish ball. St. V's offense now getting another chance to try to head down and score after the fourth down stop. 7:50 remaining in the third. Hands it off to Terrence Keyes, and he'll get a short gain of about four on the play. That'll bring up second and six. Ball on the 48. Throw to number 25, Russell Cooper, and he'll get the first and more. Looks like we have an injury on the field. Maybe two. With someone on both teams down.
We have a winning number.
While we wait to see if the injured player is okay, let us hear from Friends and Family Credit Union.
Are you looking for something different? At Friends and Family Credit Union, our success is defined by you. Our goal is to improve your financial needs and better your lifestyle. Friends and Family Credit Union provides loans, savings, checking, and other financial services to anyone who lives, works, worships, or attends school in Stark County. Our friendly staff is fully committed to serving over 11,000 of its members. What are you waiting for? Stop in one of our locations today to become a friend of the family.
Thank you, Friends and Family Credit Union. Let's get back to the game.
Both injured players making it off the field. One of them was number 25, Russell Cooper, for the Irish. First and 10, ball on the 37 for the Irish. Lindsay hands it off to number 34, Terrence Keys. He'll have about a gain of 3 on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 8. Massillon's defense has done a great job stopping the run here tonight. .621 remaining in the third quarter. Lindsay will drop back. It'll be rushed. And it's a fumble recovered by the Tigers. Another turnover from the Irish. And there looks to be another injured player from the Irish after that turnover. The Irish now with 3 turnovers. That'll make it 1st and 10, ball in the 35. Hand off to Thomas. He has a lane. Big gain by Thomas. That'll be 1st and 10 on the 48-yard line. .550 remaining in the third. Another handoff to Thomas. And that'll be a short gain of maybe 1. Thomas will limp off the field. Number 29, Zion Pfeiffer, will come in the game. 2nd and 8, ball in the 50. 5:15 remaining in the third. Longwell will pass. Number 32, Adric Ford. And he will have a short gain of about 2. Almost being hit behind the line of scrimmage, and we have another injured player for Massillon.
While they tend to this injured player, let's hear a word from John George's convenience store.
One of the most recognizable names in Massillon is John George's drive-thru. Their fresh-made deli sandwiches are well-known throughout the Massillon area. John George's will make special order lunches for your group or outing using only the finest ingredients. John George's has a large selection of snacks, drinks, and much more for a quick in-and-out. If you're really in a hurry, use John George's convenient drive-thru service. Stop by John George's drive-thru, located at 32nd Street and Lincoln Way West.
Thank you, John George's convenience store. Let's get back to the game.
3rd and 6, ball on the 48 for the Tigers. Longwell drops back to pass. He'll throw to number 32, Adrian Ford, and he's got it. And he'll have the first, and he'll break a tackle. That's another first down for the Tigers. Adric Ford, another Tiger, having a great night. First and 10, ball on the 40. Longwell drops back. Throws number 7, Trayvon Morgan, and he drops it. Four minutes remaining in the third quarter. As Morgan drops the pass as he's hit, bringing up 2nd and 10 for the Tigers. Longwell drops back once again. And he'll run. He'll be hit, but it's a catch. He's hit as he throws, and he throws number 32, Adric Ford. Ford with the catch, but Ford is down. What an amazing catch by Adric Ford. And what an amazing throw by Aiden Longwell.
MCTV invests in our town and the technology that powers it, bringing you more.
While we tend to this injured player, we're going to take a break.
It's your business, literally. The member businesses of the Downtown Massillon Association are here for you. In addition to providing our hometown families with great shopping opportunities and retail, service, and so much more, the Downtown Massillon Association is also proud to provide great events throughout the year. To plan for your next great shopping experience and for a list of this year's events, visit us at www.downtownmassillon.net. The Downtown Massillon Association, welcome home.
Thank you, Downtown Massillon Association. Let's get back to the game.
The injured player, number 32, Agent Ford, was able to walk off the field on his own strength. First and 10 for the Tigers. Ball on the 15. 3:40 remaining in the third quarter. Handoff, number 29, Zion Pfeiffer. He'll get about a 5-yard gain on the play. Second and 5 for the Tigers. Ball on the 10-yard line. 3:10 remaining in the third. Jameer Thomas back in the game for the Tigers. Longwell throws, the number 7, Trayvon Morgan, and it's caught! Touchdown, Tigers! Number 7, Trayvon Morgan. Tigers stretching their lead out even farther with another touchdown catch. Aiden Longwell with 2 touchdown passes here tonight. The kick is up and it's good. And that'll be a flag on the Tigers. Is up and good. That'll make it 27-7. The Tigers gaining a big lead against the Irish.
We'll be right back with more action after this word from BW3s in Massillon.
In nature, red means danger. The red dart frog, deadly. The red mamba, deadly. Those red triangles on a black widow, you see where we're going with this. So when you foolishly think this is an opportunity to make a name for yourself, remember both nature and our menu warned you. So maybe pick a color more pleasing to your fragile palate. May we suggest something in the green to yellowish section?
Thank you, Buffalo Wild Wings. Let's get back into the game.
Tigers getting ready to kick it off. Number 13, Joshua Jones, back for the Irish. Number 20, the kick is off. Jones will receive the kick. And he goes down at about the 21. The Massillon special teams have been very good tonight. Only giving up one big run so far tonight and having their own kick return earlier in the first half. That'll be first and 10 on the 15-yard line for the Irish. 2:54 remaining in the third. The Irish offense hoping to bring this large lead down. Hand off to 34, Terrence Keys. And he only gains about two on the short run. The Tiger defense almost completely shutting down the Irish run game here tonight. Holding the Irish so far to only 75 yards here in the third. Remaining. Second and 8. Ball on the 17. Lindsay drops back. He's under pressure and he runs. Gains about 2. After a very good first half for Lindsay, he's been slowed down tremendously in the second half so far. Minute 40 remaining in the third. Third and 5, ball on the 20. Irish looking to keep this drive going. Lindsay drops back, throws, and it's caught by number 13, Joshua Jones. That'll be first down and a little more for the Irish. Number 9, Luke Lindsay, keeping this drive alive. That'll be bring up first and 10, ball on the 27. Minute 10 remaining in the third. Hand off to another number 34, Terrence Keys, and he's stopped in the backfield for what looks to be a loss of about 3 yards. The Tiger defense not allowing the Irish to get going whatsoever in their run game here tonight. That'll bring up second and 13 for the Irish. Ball on the 24. Lindsay passes, and it's deflected. And 23 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Third and 13, ball on the 24 after the incomplete pass. The Irish are going to have a difficult time getting this third down. This Tiger defense so far has been on point tonight. And they're ready to once again stop the Irish from scoring. A bad snap. He goes out and he's sacked for a big loss. That'll bring up fourth down for the Irish with 14 seconds remaining in the quarter, and that's ticking down. The Irish will have to punt this one away. And that's the end of the third quarter. Tigers lead the Irish 28-7.
We'll be back with fourth quarter action after this word from Medicap Pharmacy.
Hi, I'm Chris Kingsbury, and welcome to Medicap Pharmacy.
Everyone knows it's the people that make the difference at your local Medicap Pharmacy.
Oh, yes, I've been coming here for 15 years.
Oh, they're so friendly. You walk in and they know you, they call you by name.
Well, this is my drugstore. I don't live too far, and they're nice people.
And don't forget about their free delivery. Support your locally owned independent Medicap Pharmacy, located on Lincoln Way West in Massillon.
Thank you, Medicap Pharmacy. Let's get back to the game.
The Tiger defense once again stopping that Irish offense. Making adjustments to stop number 9, Luke Lindsay, from what he was doing in the first half. It's very impressive how they came out here tonight and almost shutting this team down completely. The Irish will punt it away here at the beginning of the fourth. Back deep for the Tigers, number 7, Trayvon Morgan, and number 32, Adria Ford. Trayvon Morgan will receive the kick. And it will be a fair catch. Jameer Thomas so far with 100 yards. Great night for him in the season opener. Tigers will start on the 50-yard line. Handoff to Jameer Thomas. Short gain for Thomas, about 3 yards. The Tigers so far tonight, as the Tigers offense has turned it around here in the second, very much. Second and 7, ball on the 47. Handoff to Jameer Thomas. And he'll be close to the first down, but just not there yet. 11:03 remaining in the game. Third and 2 for the Tigers. Running down this play clock. Another handoff to Thomas, and he will get the first down. Or he may be close, but he may not have gotten the first. That'll bring up third and 2 for the Tiger. Fourth and 2. Wait. That'll be fourth and 1 for the Tigers. Ball on the 41. 10 minutes remaining in the game. Tigers will go for it here on fourth down. Handoff to number 29, Zion Piper, and he gets the first down. That's another first down this half for that Massillon offense. Coming out of the locker room with a new energy. That'll be first and 10, ball on the 37. 9:30 remaining in the game. Longwell, the handoff to Pfeiffer. And he'll get about a gain of 5 on the run. .905 remaining in the game. Second and 4, ball on the 31. Another long will pass to number 19, Dean Clark, and he will run into the end zone for another Massillon Tiger touchdown. Number 19, Dean Clark. The Tigers just stretching this game out of reach for the Irish. Longwell, the connection to number 19, Dean Clark. And the extra point is good. Massillon lead the Irish 35-7 here in the fourth.
Now for a word from Expert Auto Collision.
For nearly 40 years, Expert Auto Collision has been serving Stark County with premium customer service and collision repair. Bring your wrecked vehicle and they'll immediately get to work with you and your insurance company to get your vehicle back to pre-accident condition. Expert Auto Collision's professional crew has the experience and the drive to bring your damaged vehicle back to life.
Don't let an accident get your goat. Come see me, Tara, at Expert Auto Collision, the only female-owned and operated collision repair center in Northeast Ohio.
Expert Auto Collision, where we meet good people by accident.
Thank you, Expert Auto Collision. Let's get back to this game.
The Tigers stretching their lead out immensely here in the fourth. 8:41 remaining in the game. The Tigers so far having a very good overall game. Playing good special teams offense and defense throughout the entire game. Tigers kick it off. Irish get it. He's got a lane, and he will be taken down around the 33-yard line. That'll be first and 10 for the Irish on the 33-yard line. 8:33 remaining in the game. The Irish so far tonight making a lot of mistakes on the offensive end. Lindsay passes the 34, Terrence Keys. He'll gain about a yard or two. Massillon's defense has been able to stop this Irish offense almost throughout this entire game. Bring up second and 7. Ball in 38. 7:55 remaining in the game. The Tigers with a huge lead against the Irish. Lindsay will drop back He will pass it deep, and it'll be overthrown. His intended target was number 13, Joshua Jones, but it was just over him. And that'll bring up 3rd and 7 for the Irish, another 3rd down for this Irish offense. They've had trouble getting anything done so far this half on both sides of the ball. Lindsay will drop back. He's under pressure, and he's sacked, and he fumbles, and it's recovered by the Tigers. Once again, the Tiger offense will hit the field as another fumble from the Irish offense. That'll be 1st and 10 Tigers, ball on the 40 with 7:29 remaining in the game. The Tigers hoping to cut this clock down some more and hopefully stretch this lead out once again. Number 26, Marcellus Blake, in a running back. And a pass to number 9, Jaden Ballard. And he just misses it. Flag on the play. That'll be pass interference on the Irish. That'll be 1st and 10 on the 40, 7:24 remaining in the fourth. We'll have a penalty on Massillon. 2nd and 10 on the 40. Or they bring back the pass interference. Handoff to number 26, Marcellus Blake. He'll have a gain about 6 yards. Third and 4 for the Tigers. Zion Pfeiffer in at running back. 6:50 remaining. Tigers hoping to keep the ball out of the Irish offense's hands. Hand off to Pfeiffer. Just shy of the 1st down. Bringing up 4th and 1 for the Tigers. Once again, ball on the 34. 6:10 remaining in the game. The Tigers will go for it. Marcellus Blake back in at running back. Hand off to Blake. And looks like he will get it. That'll be another 1st down for the Massillon offense here in the 4th quarter. They just keep moving the chains here tonight in the 2nd half. 1st and 10, ball in the 29, 5:40 remaining. 5 seconds left on the play clock. 2-1. That'll be a delay game on the Tigers. They got the timeout before The play clock ran out. That'll be a timeout, Tigers, with 5:29 remaining.
At this timeout, let's hear a word from Tower Industries. Thank you, Tower Industries. Now let's get back into this game.
First and 10, ball in the 29. Tigers with a big lead against the Irish. 5:29 remaining in the game. Hand off to Blake. And he'll get another first down for the Tigers. A big run for number 26, Marcellus Blake. Another injured player for the Irish. Maslin's offense not slowing down here.
On behalf of the students and staff of WHS-TV, we wish to thank all of our season-long sponsors of Maslin Tiger Football. Without your support, we would not be able to bring you your Tiger Football on all of WHS-TV's media channels. So again, thanks to all of our season-long sponsors. We couldn't do it without you.
Irish player able to walk off the field on his own strength. First and 10, ball on the 13. The Tigers not slowing down. 5:22 remaining in the game. Hand off to number 26, Marcellus Blake. He'll have a short gain of maybe a yard. Five minutes remain in the game. Second and eight, ball on the 11. He'll get about another gain of two on the run. .420 remaining in the game. It'll bring up third and 7 for the Tigers. Ball on the 10. Four minutes remaining in the ball game. Longwell drops back. He throws it up, and it is almost intercepted by the Irish. .359 remaining in the game. It'll bring up fourth down for the Tigers. Fourth and 7, the Tigers will go for a field goal. The kick is no good for the Tigers. The score will stay 35-7. As the Irish will once again get a chance. to lighten the score.
Now for a word from our WHS Alumni Association.
Just what does the Washington High School Alumni Association do?
Why, every year, we honor select grads as distinguished citizens.
This past spring, we awarded 27 scholarships, averaging $1,000 each.
We keep you connected through class reunions and birthday parties.
We also sponsor the WHS Homecoming, Alumni Band, and the Choir Alumni.
So join and contribute today, the Washington High School Alumni Association.
Thank you, WHS Alumni Association. Now let's get back to the game.
We're back as the Irish get a big run. That'll be one of the first big runs they'll have this game. Number 20 for the Irish. 3:49 remaining in the game. First and 10, ball on the 33 for the Irish. Looks now to have their backups in as this game has become almost out of reach for them with 3:15 remaining. Second and 7, ball in the 36.
Second and 7 on the 36.
3 minutes remaining. Hand off to number 20 for the Irish. He'll have a short gain. 2:45 remaining in the game. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
It's
2:30 remaining in the game. Tigers hoping to keep the Irish from scoring at all in the second half. 2:10 remaining. And the Irish will be stopped in the backfield, bringing up 4th down once again. 1:50 remaining in the game. Fourth and 7, ball in the 36. 1:30 remaining. The Irish are going to go for it here. A low snap. That'll be another turnover on downs for the Irish. Once again, the Massillon offense takes the field. 1:18 remaining in the game. 1st and 10, ball in the 36 for the Tigers. Tigers playing a great game here tonight. Short gain on the play by number 26, Marcellus Blake. A minute remaining in the game. That'll be 2nd and 9. The Tigers begin to just let the clock tick down. With 45 seconds remaining in the game, the Tigers will win this game. with a huge lead. What a great night the Tigers have had on both sides of the field and special teams. And that'll wrap up the game. Your score at the end of the Massillon Tigers season opener, Tigers 35, Irish 7. Tigers win here tonight in a very exciting game, putting on a show, completely blowing out Akron, St. Vincent, St. Mary's. They played amazing on both sides of the field, and in the second half were unable to be stopped by the Irish. Once again, your final score, Tigers 35, Irish 7. As we wrap up tonight's coverage of Massillon Tiger football, we want to take time to thank the members of our WHS-TV crew. Tonight's production crew includes Billy Burek, Nicholas McCartney, Jada Moore, Josh Perry, and Daniel Stewart on camera, Kyle Slagle on color commentary, and me, Keyshawn Dorsey, your play-by-play commentator. Also, thanks to our directors, Mr. Farrell and Mr. DeWald. And for all of you, from all of us at WHS-TV, thanks for watching. And as always, go Tigers.
Now this final word from Massillon Cable TV.
For over 50 years, MCTV has kept our community and your home connected. We invest in our hometown and the technology that powers it, bringing you faster speeds, sharper pictures, stronger connections, and better local service that's sure to make you smile. Because with us, you're more than a customer. You're also our neighbor. MCTV, we go the extra smile.
And these places are getting old. I said these places and these places are getting old. So I'm going home. I'm going
home. I got to high school, I noticed there was all this like media production stuff. And I said, oh, there's a class for this? I can do this in high school now?
It was just an easy decision for me to sign up for telepro from the beginning. I kind of knew going into high school that was what I was going to do and want to get involved with. And it was just a great space for me to kind of just build up some experience and get stuff that, you know, other people aren't going to have the opportunity to do at that age.
My teachers were Mr. Sheets and Mr. DeWald. And I took the TV production class because I had a growing interest in TV and film production.
I wanted to be a professional sports play-by-play broadcaster. I was willing to, I wanted to hook on with a team, and I wanted to travel with the team and be a part of it year-round. That's what I wanted 24/7.
As soon as I get to the high school, I'm signing up for WHS-TV because I feel like that's going to be my launching point.
Loved movies. I wanted to work in movies. I remember watching a lot of the old movies like Animal House and Breakfast Club and just fell in love with that, fell in love with storytelling, and that was what I wanted to do. I didn't know exactly what I wanted to do in it, but I knew that I wanted to entertain people. And so I started the program and kind of found my way from there.
The story of my life, I take her home, I drive all night to keep her warm in time. I give a hope, I spend a love in time.
heart open. We are as old as CBS Television's 60 Minutes news program. We are as old as George Romero's Night of the Living Dead. That was, a, I mean, 50 years. We're 50. We're 50. We're 50 years old. That is a huge, huge deal. That's, I love that. We're almost as old as TV, sort of. We are older than color TV, and that's neat.
We had no one to pattern after because we were the first. So there was one classroom that had been converted into the studio with a glass window. The middle classroom had been converted into a control room. And then beyond that was another classroom where you teach the students.
We started the TV era at Washington High School. There was only a handful of us. We all graduated together. Bill DeWald was our camera and overall tech guru. A guy named Fred Hayden was our audio guy.
And it was really a speech class. There was no such thing as a TV class. That no one ever thought about that. So it was kind of an offshoot from the speech department. The original studio was pretty small. Of course, the old high school had tall ceilings, so that was beneficial. Great big lights. Not enough air conditioning, so it was very hot. And of course, the control room was, by today's standards, just filled with this big old clunky gray metallic equipment. There were two studio style cameras. I think there was a third camera that was just like for extra stuff. And a very, very early switcher and a videotape recorder, one inch videotape recorder. But it was the very beginning of that. We were doing something that you couldn't do.
Well, I remember actually coming to a program at the high school where there was some students videotaping a program in the auditorium, and I thought, that's pretty cool. I would like to be part of that. So when I came to the high school, I got involved with the WHS-TV.
I mean, you really think about it, what a revolutionary idea. It was the late 60s, and you wanted to broadcast stuff from the high school out into the community. And it was unheard of, to say the least, but the people at the high school believed, and the people at Massillon Cable Television believed, and before you know it, it actually happened.
I was probably the only one there, George Lehner and myself, probably, and Fred Hayden was another student, and we tried to just kind of get together and figure it out, make it work, and there really were no adults in the, other than the people from the cable company, and they really didn't understand it either. It was all very new.
We started out doing the morning announcement accent show on audio. And then when we started the TV component, we started out doing the accent announcements on TV. And you could actually watch that on Massillon Cable.
We added video to that, but it was initially in the very, very early days, it was just graphics. We didn't try to put anyone on camera because we couldn't edit. I don't know of anybody that's ever created a TV station for the community out of their high school the way Washington High School did.
We were producing and we were announcing and we were actually doing all the camera work for live programming.
But we were so fortunate to have the opportunity to do what we did. We had the support of our teachers, Mr. Cheney, who did telecommunications work, Mr. Mogus taught speech. We did work in Struts and Frets with Alan Dawson.
We thought we were really something because we were doing something that couldn't be done.
But when you go back to where it all began in high school, I was always so proud of what we were able to do at WHS-TV.
To take students from a small town in Ohio that doesn't really have any connection to like a Hollywood or a big city or something like that, and actually get people out in the industry that were, and those seeds were planted very early on as students, and they would grow. And we've got lots of people that made it into the
the business, and that would not have happened had it not been for this high school TV thing. Few, if any, have been able to recreate it, and I think that speaks volumes about the creativity that went into the program as it exists now.
We have been on the air longer than most TV stations, longer than most radio stations, and I don't even mean from a high school and college standpoint. I mean, period.
The story is my life.
We really do have a lot of kids that have gone on and had successful careers. You know, not like making millions and millions of dollars, but certainly doing well, you know, supporting a family and making a good living and enjoying what they do.
How this program has nurtured these young people, and so many of them have gone on into television and all kinds of communication work. And so it's really very gratifying that that we've sort of started all this, and you people have carried it on so beautifully. So it's wonderful.
I think it's pretty special that they get some experiences like that, to stand in front of a camera, to edit something, to kind of get a sense as to how that industry works, learn a little bit about the magic behind the scenes. And it changes your life, the way you look at movies, the way you look at television, and the way you trust, you know, a photograph, because you learn, you know, how powerful like Photoshop is. You don't look at anything quite the same as you had before. WHS has always been of, by, and for the students to learn how to produce television and now new media.
There's a lot of really, really talented people that have come through this program over the last 50 years that are doing some really great things in television, radio, film, live entertainment, and they all got their start here. And they went a million different directions, but they all have that media arts component. None of that knowledge was wasted. They just used it in a different way.
WHS helped me in my professional career by giving me access to professional-grade equipment. We had Avid when I was in school there, and to this day, Avid Media Composer is what I work on for all of the shows that I do, and it was a huge leg up for me having access to the type of equipment that I'd be working on professionally in Los Angeles, and I didn't realize it when I was there, but it was such a huge help to me and really gave me the edge when I came out here and already knew what I was doing on the system.
I think that it was a very great opportunity for me to get to know the industry of teleproductions. In my personal life, I've gone on to do public speaking and things like that, and that had a lot to do with being on camera and that.
Personally, just the development that they had, it was all about, they had deadlines, they kept us on task, they were adamant that things were done at times. It was just accountability was the key, and you have to learn that, and they did such a great job instilling that in all of us. That's something that, whether you're going to stay in broadcast or stay in this sort of field or not, you have to have that professionally in your career. You have to have that level of professionalism and ability to work with people and meet deadlines and go through all those things. So that was the part that was the most invaluable to that. It really prepared you, prepared me for careers down the road.
I think it's given me a drive to be better and keep on doing things no matter how many times you fail.
Teleproductions ended up helping me a lot in my career because it set me on the path. Initially, like I said, I wanted to be a game programmer, so I took the class in order to learn lighting techniques, storytelling techniques, and editing techniques to improve how I told a story through a video game.
So if it wasn't for this class, I never would have gone to Full Sail. I never would have got to work on Keeping Up with the Kardashians or The Real World or those shows that they a lot of those really bad reality TV shows that they make out there.
Been on the air on a lot of different call signs, and it wouldn't have been possible if it weren't for WHS-TV and especially Mr. Sheets. Mr. Sheets was really a big influence on me. He was a big influence in my career. And Mr. DeWald as well. Mr. DeWald brought the technical side of things. Mr. Sheets brought the creative side of things, and really fostered that and nurtured that within me. And I owe them a debt of gratitude for that.
Public presentation is still a huge part of a successful career, regardless of whether it's in sales or in communications, or you know, whether it's corporate life or running your own business. You have to be, you know, you get great skill, great mileage out of learning how to talk to people, and you certainly do that in this program.
I learned a lot of technical stuff. I learned how to run a camera. I learned all the different departments. I learned what white balance was, and you know, I learned the basic terms. So when I went to college, it definitely helped me because I was ahead of where a lot of other people were. I knew the fundamentals of what I needed to do in order to do my job that I do now.
Giving students access to the tools they need to get a head start in the industry is really cool. And you just don't see that, like, really anywhere else. I mean, for like a little town in Ohio, Massillon punches way above its weight.
Always a deadline. There's always, it's a time frame. You gotta get it done. And you gotta always look at every detail too. I think it's made me more detail-oriented too. Always questioning, like, is this right? I don't know if this is right. Let's look at this again and see. No, it's not right. Glad we double-checked things, because it's a matter of, in this business, if it's not right, someone's going to notice it and it's going to look off.
All that television work and all that comfort level started at WHS-TV.
Basic knowledge and the basic skills that come with organizing a group of people to produce something. You know, to think in an orderly fashion and put those sorts of things together, or those who are on the other side in front of the camera, the courage that it takes to stand up and look, whether it's the television camera in the eye or the person you're interviewing in the eye, and you know, sort of take that bold step and say, okay, I'm going to say something to a group of people.
But I got to do a lot of stuff. I got to be in the offices. I got to meet the executives. I got to go to the Real World House. That was kind of neat in 2007.
I've been nominated for an Emmy for one of the shows I work on, which is Central Florida Spotlight. And some of the other ones have been, I've worked on several films, and they were really fun to work on. They've been Battleship, 21 Jump Street, and Twilight Breaking Dawn Part 1 and 2.
Won a lot of awards for sports broadcasts and journalism awards, and you know, studying journalism, studying writing, studying speech. And having the hands-on communication skills honed in when you started in high school, I mean, you can't say enough about what that experience does for you later in life.
My work on Freak Show for AMC, my work on Spartan Ultimate Team Challenge for NBC, and my current work on American Ninja Warrior for NBC. I've been a professional television editor for over a decade now. It's a really, really challenging career. I've spent 90-hour weeks, 80-hour weeks back-to-back working on shows when we're up against the deadline, but it's also been a very rewarding career.
Got the opportunity to be able to join the union, become a union member. That was a huge thing for me. That meant that I actually had a solid career in this field. And the other one would be working on Warner Brothers Backlot. That was a huge one for me when I got that phone call that I actually got to work at WB. It was a big moment for me. I was extremely excited about it. It was one that I always wanted to work at. I've definitely got to work at a lot of the major studios now, and that it's a good feeling.
Very cool to think that, you know, you're in the same room as somebody like Barack Obama. He's just right over there. You know, you're in the same room. George W. Bush, he was currently sitting president, and he was in the same room as me. I mean, who am I? I'm just some kid from Massillon. But here I am. And I'm able to do that. And to me, that's just really impressive. And I could not have done that if it weren't for WHS Teleproductions.
Moved to LA, worked on Planet's Funniest Animals, a reality show called Don't Forget the Lyrics with Wayne Brady. I worked on that OJ confession thing that they just released a couple weeks ago. They supposedly damaged the tapes, and here it is. Which is, to me, is crazy. 13 or so years later, I'm on the OJ thing. Worked on Real World, Keeping Up with the Kardashians, a lot of the Buna Murray stuff that they do.
Well, you don't do it by yourself, certainly. And you look back at the people that you've worked with and the people that you've met along the way.
The best part of this is that, you know, we all had to work together no matter what. It was just no matter who you were friends with, no matter what, we all worked together and everybody was just there to be a team in order to get what we needed to get done.
Friendships that last to this day. You know, I'm still in touch with a number of classmates and colleagues from WHS-TV. It's been years and we're still in touch, which is just absolutely a wonderful thing.
You know, my experiences there and with that program have you know, showed me what it was like to be part of a team and to be a professional. And whether you're, you know, whether you're in broadcast or you're in, you know, another career field or anything you're doing, that's so extremely vital. And I think I've been able to take those lessons with me, you know, moving forward.
It is a collaborative thing. So in order to really kind of get out there, stay who you are, stay humble, stay sweet, and jobs will find you.
I watch some of your current broadcasts and I am so envious. I mean, it would have been so cool to have had that equipment and that technology back in the day.
The students have a much better chance of having their work seen by either the general public or down the road a potential employer. Absolutely. All we had was the old high school TV channel before. Now we've got all the social media aspects. We have our Facebook page, we have our YouTube channel, and everything that goes along with that.
In the case of WHS-TV, tremendously successful because we can see the product is seen every day by people in the community and they applaud it. So the students do a wonderful job. The administrators and the instructors do a great job of teaching. It's kept pace with technology and with the change of the communications environment. So it's been a very successful program.
You can't fake history and you can't make up history. So to be legitimately, genuinely part of that program from a student standpoint, and then come back as an instructor standpoint and have that kind of history. I mean, I didn't start this, but it's almost like an Olympic torch. You have the opportunity to carry or help carry that torch. Even if I'm here for, whether it's 1 year or 30 years, the point is you were here and it went forward because of your contributions.
Congratulations to WHS-TV. I've always been proud of my hometown. I've always loved my school. And I'm so proud of what we were able to achieve in telecommunications and what everyone at that school has been able to continue to achieve.
Open up the champagne, pop.
This is WHS-TV.
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 Your story starts here.
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 And your story starts here.
Your story.
Your story
starts here.
Starts here.
This is WHS-TV. Your story starts here. Welcome to
my house. It's my house.
Perfect. Good.
Fantastic job that you just did on that high note. I want more of that. Where'd you go, tenors?
Leaving to find my soul. Told her I had to go. And I know it ain't pretty.
I will
What do you do?
I'm just chilling. Why?
Oh.
I hope someday we'll sit down together and laugh with each other about these days. All our troubles we'll lay to rest and we'll wish we could come back to these days
that only go in one direction.
Who's the best class in this building?
218, come on now.
218, that's what I'm saying.
About these days, all our troubles will lead to rest.
Means that some knucklehead went out on a Friday night and cracked a cold one with the boys. Except the boys were fish. Brilliant.
Now, this is a scam if I've ever seen one. This is purple, and I'm a bit upset. Gordon Ramsay would not bear the shame of this one.
Like a pastime, I could cry you a river, get you baptized, or I wasn't ready to act.
Travis just broke up with me.
I know some songs that'll help you out.
When you're gone,
this is the tool to remind us who we are and that we are not alone when we're walking in the dark.
I hope someday
cold never bothered me anyway.
All our troubles will lay to rest.
No, you guys can't peek around the corner and not expect to be on accent.
Someday we'll sit down together and laugh with each other about
if we can't see air, can fish see water?
I'm already done with these questions.
To rest and we wish we could come back to these days.
It was a fantastic, amazing drop of cascading pastel colored orbs. It was phenomenal.
These days.
I believe that we will win. 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 We're gonna move to Brooklyn. You were gonna study art. Love is just a tool to remind us who we are and that we are not alone when we're walking in the dark.
I hope someday we'll sit down together.
Like, just making something and having people go, wow, that's really interesting. It means the world.
We wish we could come back to these days. We wish we could come back to these days.
Here I am, rock you like a hurricane.
joined cosmetology because I've always loved coloring hair and different colors and makeup.
I joined media because I've always had a passion for all things related to media.
I've always had a passion for teaching other people, especially topics that I'm interested in.
I want to pursue a career as an orthopedic surgeon. And so when I saw that we had this class, I immediately circled it on my schedule and was excited to join.
This class has made me better because it made me very responsible.
I like the relationships that I've developed in this class.
The girls that are in here with me, I've really grown close with all of them.
I joined this class because I enjoy helping others and I want to make a difference.
Even like just making something and having people go, wow, that's really interesting. It means the world.
It was just a really good environment to be in. It was real hands-on and it was just something I really wanted to do.
I joined the construction trades to gain experience in the job I want in the future.
Everything that this class has taught me will account for my career in the future.
Before I came to this class, I was unemployed and Ms. Markley helped me get a job.
I'm going to use what I learned in manufacturing in order to better decide my career.
It gave me more knowledge on cars and gave me plans to go in the auto industry.
Massillon CTE works for me.
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 Works for me.
For me.
For me.
Massillon CTE works for me.